Section, container, div block, these are all elements that can organize your site's content. But you may be asking yourself, when do I use each of these? First off, let's get one thing straight. They're all basically div blocks, but with their own presets. Let's quickly recap what each of them do. A section, by default, takes up the full width of the page. These are usually placed right into the page body. A container is a Webflow element that comes with a predefined width and stays centered. And a div block? Well, a div block can be anything you want it to be. Content wrapper, divider, grid to hold your images, you name it. But here's a common hierarchy when building your web page. We have sections that act like chapters on a page, like a hero section, feature section, testimonial section, and so on. Inside each section is a container, so the container can keep all the content throughout the page neatly bound towards the center. And a div block is anything else you want it to be. In this example, we have a div block to organize and constrain just the content inside, so we can set specific width properties on just the div block. Now, this is not the only way to build. You don't have to use all these elements. In fact, a lot of designers and developers will just use a series of div blocks inside div blocks to build a structure that makes sense for their design. So instead of using the container element, they'd use a custom div block that's maybe narrower than the section and keeps the content inside legible and centered. But one thing to keep in mind, the section is a semantic element that implies the content inside is a distinct section of the page with a specific purpose. So using a section helps search engines and screen readers to understand that this content is thematically grouped, so it's improving both the visibility and the user experience. But again, the important thing to remember is as long as you're creating functional groupings for content on the page, you can use whatever makes sense for your site. So let's recap. You can use sections to stack page content vertically. Then you can add containers to keep all of the page content centered and legible. And finally, you can use div blocks to hold and organize other content inside the containers. But again, you don't have to use these. You can just use div blocks to structure and organize your content if it makes sense for your site. Now, if you're still asking yourself, when do I use each of these? First off, let's get one thing straight. They're all basically div blocks.